Looked like Passos had brought us to the right place. That was the chopper the Commando Sombra used to escape the nightclub attack. If Fabiana wasn't around here, then at least someone that knew where she was had to be. Here I was, some hopped-up gringo a long way from home, making trouble the only way I knew. As the weather worsened, I caught a glimpse of the rusted shells of previous lives that had been lived out here in this swampy shithole, and I wondered if I would end up the same way, or what would happen to that girl I was supposed to protect. A bullet will sometimes work as well as a key. As part of me would rather be anywhere else, I knew this was where I had to be. I felt responsible. I just had to fix the situation, right here. I couldn't understand them, but I didn't have to. Cheap hoods are the same from here to Timbuktu. The slab of meat on the boat was clearly the boss. Serrano, they called him. And it seemed that our suspicions were correct. Fabiana was here, somewhere further ahead. I had to find her quickly and quietly if possible. Last thing I wanted was a party with these clowns. Guessed the center of the maze was in this direction. I kept moving toward the signs of life, rubbing them out as I went along. I'd seen enough to know that Fabiana was at least alive, if not exactly well. Her captors didn't look like they were quite the kind and gentle type. I had to find that room quickly.
Oh, cara. Para de mentira.
Vai se fuder, cara.
Vai tomar no meio do cu.
Eu vou te meter bala, hein.
Vá se fuder, porra.
Oi, Dani. Você tá aí? Você tem um cigarro?
Think about what would be happening on that video feed now. Just my own imminent cameo. I'd seen was somewhere up ahead. I had to keep moving. I hoped that I'd find Fabiana sooner than later, if at all.
Ah!
That was the chair that she had been held in. I had just missed them. Here we go again. They'd been making a reality show starring São Paulo's favorite housewife. Probably thought it would grease the wheels with the ransom money, but it only made me want to shove the cash down their throats. She was on the move. If they'd finally decided to kill her, I wasn't doing anything to persuade them otherwise. I could hear drilling through the wall. It sounded more like boat hull than bone, but I needed to be sure. There she was, right in front of me. The drunk fool in me wanted to make a play. But I had just about enough sense to know that I'd end up with another dead girl in my arms if I did. Serrano had taken Fabiana through the garage door. I had to find a way to open it. It seemed Serrano's boys had targeted the entire Branco family and didn't give a shit which one they pinched. Next circle of this low-rent hell. seen Fabiana in a worrying amount of time, but at least I wasn't following a trail of her fingers. I thought I might find something on the other side of the gate. I had to keep on going across the docks. I prefer to mix these with alcohol, but on this special occasion, I'd make an exception. I had to find a way to close the sluice gate so I could get across. There they were. I had the feeling I'd been running one step behind ever since I got to this country. And maybe a few years before that as well.
Where's Fabiana?
They took her in a boat. That way. Straight ahead.
Okay, don't worry. Hang on.
Boy, did I need to hang on. The whole operation was slipping out of our grip. I was an overconfident jump of going into the jungle alone. Shit!
More company!
How's she look, man? My gun!
Beat up, broken, a lot. I don't know what to say.
Jesus Christ! Fuck!
Hey, that's them. We're back.
Nice job.
I'm sure they missed us.
That's us on your right! Look out! Get in that pool! Damn it!
Hey, I got an idea. Hold on!
Fabiana had slipped through my fingers for a second time. Another habit I didn't want or need.
It was close. We almost had her. Damn!
I don't think we ever had much of a chance. No one told us they had an entire goddamn army.
I don't think anybody knew. Crazy shit.
Yeah. It's all crazy, pal. Non-stop insanity. Thought I left all this shit behind. Easy gig, you said. What a fool I was to get involved in this madness.
Thank you.
Get up, bro. Max. Wake up, Max. Come on. Get up, you big bastard. Come on.
I'm up.
Yeah? You don't look up.
Just give me a second, will you? I'm really not feeling too good.
Hey, Max, what is it with you in interior design? Huh? You really know how to give a place that great lived-in feel, huh? This is beautiful.
Fuck off with the fucking wisecracks. Really, I'm not in the mood.
Okay, sorry, bro. The boss wants to see us, so let's go, come on. Take your time, man. Fucking unbelievable. Jesus.
I heard that.